what the business is, man. It's the baby, the baby, the baby, the baby. And you need to keep that thing locked to Buck TV. We here.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Do your thing, do your thing.
Man.
The baby, the baby, the baby, the baby. Man, he got my blood pumping in here, man. He done gave me the killer mix when I walk in, 10, 12 songs straight. What it do, man?
First of all, bro.
Talk to me.
Is you wearing the Huggies, bro?
These are lies. See, look, today I ain't got on the Huggies. I had the Huggies on the other day. Today I got on the pull-ups. I'm a big boy today. Hold on, I'm a big boy today, man. I got on the pull-ups and I'm coordinating. I got the gray ones on because they, you know, they match with the J's. So that's how I'm rocking out today, you feel me? I got some extra ones in the car. If you, I don't know if we wear the same size, you feel me? But if we do, I can put you on the wave, you feel me?
Bro, is you wearing a pamper, bro?
You know I am. You know that's how I came in here.
You say you got playing. Some extras in the car.
I got like the 12 pack. You know what I'm saying? Like I just left a baby shower. Matter of fact, I'm finna throw a party. We gonna call it the baby shower. You feel me? I need everybody to drop off them pampers for me so I can have them. You know what I'm saying? For the rest of my life. That's just how we gonna do it. I'm loving the way they responding, man. So I think I need a lifetime supply of them. I think I got some endorsements on the way.
Oh
yeah.
Oh. Bro, we could talk all day, me and you. We got to. I don't know if you're in a rush. I don't know where you got to go.
Nah, whatever you want to do, man. Whatever you want to do, we here.
And I asked you things, so I'm going to ask you this live on camera. Is there anything that I can or cannot ask you in this interview?
Nah, do your thing. We here. All
right.
Yeah, we here. It's me. You know what I'm saying?
Baby Jesus right now.
The baby.
DJ Meddi Meddi. Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, the baby.
You know the baby. Saying?
Yeah, it's the baby. It's officially the baby. It's nothing but the baby.
Okay. Buck TV.
Yeah, Buck TV. You know he always gonna get the, you know, the new and exclusives. I say Buck when he walked. I say Buck, why you ain't got me in that diaper yet, Buck? I say, what? That's not like you. I said, that's not like you. But yeah, we hit on, man.
Streets 103.3. The city you repping,
Charlotte.
You been on the road.
Mm-hmm. Nonstop.
City to city.
Yep. State to state.
This record light show.
I got a whole lot of diamonds.
I asked a bunch of female bloggers.
Mm-hmm.
I said, what questions y'all want me to ask the baby when he come up here?
Tell him, talk to me, baby.
One of them said, ask him where he's storing all them diamonds at.
Where I do what? Where I store?
Where you store the diamonds at? You got a whole lot of diamonds. Where you storing them at?
I don't store the diamonds. You know, the diamonds that I got, you know, I keep them on me, man. I don't store nothing. I don't keep nothing away. I don't hide nothing from nobody, baby. They here.
I seen you with South by Southwest.
Yeah, that was beautiful. Yeah, that was beautiful.
The ladies, they really taking to you a little bit.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I love them too, you know, so we got a mutual, you know, understanding, me and the female following that I do have. It's our love from, you know, air last one. The baby don't discriminate.
Well, you know, women love babies.
Yeah, they do. They do, you know, and I'm a different type of baby, you know, so we get along well.
Now, I seen you got King Carter behind you.
Yeah.
A dude who was an artist and now he's supporting your movement. That's big.
Yeah, that's the management side of the South Coast Music Group. So, you know, big ups to him. He probably over my right shoulder right now pointing a cell phone at me. That's my dog. You know, we here. We get it in.
I asked him, was it any names that I couldn't say in the interview? They told me we good. So Arnold Taylor.
Big homie. Big homie. That's all I'm going to say. Big homie.
My understanding, some of the acts that he's worked behind, like Future and mm-hmm. Gotti, mm-hmm. just to name two off the top of my head.
Right, you know what I'm saying?
And I spoke to him on the phone, and everybody's just saying the same thing. They said, we found an artist that had everything that we was looking for, and we want to put our bets on that artist, and that's you.
Mm-hmm.
And for the city that you come from, hip-hop artists been trying to get where you are for a minute.
Right.
Now, you know, this is a true story. Because, you know, I've been rocking with you since, you know, like the first joints, like we was just playing.
Right. Yeah, go way back.
And I remember the first time I talked to you in my office, you was very humble, you know, very relaxed.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes I see your videos, I see all that energy.
Right.
Then I see you and you be so relaxed.
Yeah. You know, you got to keep your poise.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so when you first dropped that first joint, because we was talking about some of the controversies and everything originally.
Right.
That
with the name,
we knew that
Jesus.
You may have to go through, you
right,
know?
Definitely.
And this is a true story. And I hope they watch it. This, because we talked 2 years ago, like on the dot almost.
Right.
Labels was like, who's the hot artist in your city right now?
Mm-hmm. I remember this conversation that you're talking about. I remember the exact conversation.
On the bubble up.
Right.
Dababy. I'm telling them, Def Jam, Columbia, Sony, Atlantic, 300. I'm telling all of them, sending them the product, giving them your number, everything. Mm-hmm. Now, this is a true story. So about 2 months ago, one of them labels called me back. Man, you told me about Dababy 2 years ago. Upset. Right.
Nah, you snooze, you lose, man. You snooze, you lose.
Name some of these cities that you've been to on this.
Oh, man. I don't know where to start. New York, Detroit, Philadelphia, Washington, D.C., Jackson, Mississippi, Little Rock, Arkansas, Shreveport, Louisiana, Dallas, Texas, Jacksonville, Florida, Orlando, Florida, Miami, where else, bro? Tampa, Florida, South Carolina, a bunch of cities in South Carolina, already named Detroit, Dover, Delaware, something like that. Like, it's like that. Virginia, it's like that, man. A lot of places. Cleveland, Ohio, Columbus, Ohio, Cincinnati, Ohio, Lexington, Kentucky, Louisville, Kentucky. Everywhere on this whole East Coast, Midwest, Southeast, all those, Texas, Tyler, Texas, I already named Dallas, Austin, of course, Houston. We've been all over the place with it, you know what I'm saying? We pretty much covered the whole board, you know, and had it not been the time of the year, the season that it was, we would have got a lot more covered. But, you know, the weather didn't permit that. But, yeah, we done been all over the place, and we ain't done, you know. We are not done.
So when does Dababy sleep? When's nap time?
Man, when I can get it. I sleep when I can, you know what I'm saying? So I get my Z's in, and I hop back up, and I get right back to work. But see, I'm the type of person with, like, ideas and, you know, creativity. It won't let me sleep. Like, I cannot sleep, not eat. But when I'm on to something, I'm on to something. So, you know, like, it, that type of stuff, like, it keep me fueled. And, you know, I just let my mind keep me fueled a lot of times. And, I probably need to get a little more sleep every now and then. But, you know, it's all for, you know, a great cause in the end. So I'm all for it, you know. Built for it.
So we talking Gerber? Like, what does the baby eat? What is baby food when you on the road?
Oh, nah, the baby eat. The baby like to eat good, man. You know, my Sadidi manager, man, he on,
oh,
like,
Lord.
He, bro, fancy, man, you know. But, nah, we, when, speaking of the big homie, Arnold Taylor, you know, one golden rule that he has when you on the road, you know what I'm saying? You eat when you can, you know, because it be like that. Like, when we on the road, you know, it look like all fun and games. It look like, you know, whatever. A lot of people, man, 98% of people, they not cut out for this. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's more work than anything. Like, you know, you gonna sacrifice a lot of the things that you think come with this is the exact opposite. You know what I'm saying? Like, you gotta, you know, you just gotta get it how you live. You know, so when we on the road, we eat what we pass by, you know, because when we leave here, we got to be there. When we leave there, we got to be there. You know what I'm saying? And then the next morning, we got to be up at this time to go there. So it ain't time to go out and do that. And by the time we get done doing what we doing, you know, with the itinerary, all the good food places closed anyways, man. So we pretty much, you know, it's, you know, it ain't as sweet as it look. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, the spot that I'm in, I earned that, you know. And I say that, you know, with the utmost confidence, you know what I'm saying? I earned that, you know. And it's going to take a lot more than what people think, you know, to get you to the level that I'm at. It take a lot of dedication, you know what I'm saying? Sacrificing. You just got to be all about it. You got to eat, sleep, and breathe whatever you're doing, you know, and keep the most high first.
You say you eat when you can.
Yeah, definitely.
One of the female bloggers asked me to ask you this.
What's up,
so
baby?
Since you eat when you can.
Yeah.
You walk around in a diaper.
Right.
Do you ever just take a dump in a diaper?
I'm going to try that. Man, listen. I'm going to try it. Why? Because when we be on the road, that's another thing. Hey, when we be on the road, we moving. We don't be wanting to stop, man. Like, I got to pee. We be like, what you mean? You got to pee, bro. We ready to get out this car. I might around and just, yeah. Just let me see if these things really work. You know, I might need to go get my money back. So I beat and tried it. You know, I don't know about the number two thing, but you know, I beat and tried it, man. Why not? You know, it is what it is.
A lot of people don't know race car drive. You know, Carolina is a big race car market. Race car drivers wear one piece is in.
Right.
If you driving for 4 or 5 hours, you cannot hop out the car.
You got to just go. You got to go. If you want that trophy, you know what I'm saying? You got to do what you got to do. And I want the trophy, baby. So, you know, if I ever do got one of these on and I'm doing something really important where I can't take the time out to use the bathroom, please believe I'm in there. And I'm going to look at the camera. I'm in there. All in there. Straight up. And I'm just going to hope it don't run down my leg. You know what I'm saying? But see, me, for comfort reasons, I like to, you know, wear one or two of them. So okay. I got extra coverage. You feel me? If you give me a bottle of water right now, I pour it down. I bet you won't see nothing. You know, like.
No leak.
Yeah. You know, and we reaching out to all the, you know, the big time diaper companies. Man, we need the most exclusive diapers that you got. We're going to slap the logo on the front and I'm going to put on for you. But just make sure it works. Because if I ever, you know, get into one of them situations, I'm going to do that.
I seen in one of the videos, you was like in a swimming pool, a whole bunch of beautiful women.
Oh, yeah.
I think that might be The safe sex video.
Yeah. So that I mean, fun.
So if you got the, you know, if you got the diaper on in the swimming pool, everybody done took a leak in the swimming pool.
Right, I ain't had it on in there, but you know, that's, come on now, this streets 103.3. Hey, majority of people that listen to this station, you done pissed in that swimming pool before. Quit playing. You know what I'm saying? So I don't know if these things waterproof or not, though. You know, that's something I got to try. You feel me? But you know, yeah, fun video.
Now I want to get back to some of them type topics, but. It's very, very important that I talk to you about the beginning.
Yeah, let's do it.
Because so many times we talk to artists, singers, rappers, songwriters about the beginning.
Right.
So let's go back to the beginning. What year? Because I've heard different stories.
It was December 2014.
That's like what I'm hearing.
I made my entire first mixtape, Nonfiction. I made it over like a 2 week period, and I dropped it like the second week of January 2015, like cold turkey. Like I wasn't worried about no rapping before that. Like I wasn't even thinking about it. Like it wasn't even a thought. Like I came to one of my peoples. I had some, you know, I was getting it in. I had a little money. I'm like, take me to somebody who can make the beats in front of me. You know what I'm saying? Official studio where I could record that, and boom, I'm trying to rap. They, man, quit playing. They took me there, dropped the bag on them. First song I ever made was Baby Jesus. Boom, ran with it, you know, took off running, ain't never looked back, and here we are, you know what I'm saying? Not even, 25, 26 months later.
Mm-hmm. What's the chance
of that?
Little
over 2 years.
That the first record you make
is a hit.
Smash.
Mm-hmm. That's how it happened, you know what I'm saying? So that's why I always end up going back to this, man. Like, you know, this was written, you know, this is what was supposed to happen, you feel me? So, you know, It really ain't no taking nothing away from me when it comes to this. And I always get a credit, you know, to the Most High, because the first song I ever made, like, that was it. Like, had I went in there and made a couple songs I wasn't satisfied with, which I'm sure a lot of people do, like, people who are already polished artists, who are already on, they record, and the type of songs I throw out like that, they only catch them type of songs once every 2-3 years, you know what I'm saying? Them hits. So, you know, I always been real big on that from the beginning. Like, this is just what it's supposed to be, you know, this God's work.
One of one.
Right. That's a classic too. Like, man, the list goes on. Yeah, the list goes on.
All right, so you say you took the bag, just dropped it on them.
Yeah.
I mean, would I be wrong to ask you where that first initial bag come from? Where baby money come from in the beginning?
It came from where it came from, man. With me, you know, knowing what I do, it came from where it came from. It was hard earned, you know what I'm saying? Either way it go. But, yeah, I definitely, you know, jumped out there and put the bag behind myself, you know, and that's what set me apart from a lot of other artists, a lot of other people, you know, they come into the game having somebody put the bread behind them, having somebody back them. It ain't no way you as hungry as I am when I put my own bag up in the beginning and boom, put it all behind myself, because I put it all on the line off the rip. You know what I'm saying? I continue to do that, you know, and that's what made me in the beginning. That's why that first project was like that. That's why that first song was like that. It's just relentless. Like, it is what it is. Like, this me, you know, you can't tell me nothing. That's what my very first song said. You can't tell me nothing. You feel me? So, yeah, you know, the first bag, I went around that question real good. First bag, you know, it came from where it came from, man. But, you know, that's the thing of the past. Mm-hmm.
So what you said, December 14, 2014?
Yeah, December 2014. Yeah, like right after Christmas, start recording, boom, 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 boom. Knocked the whole mixtape out and dropped it. I didn't even know what a master was, getting songs mastered or any of that. I ain't know nothing about none of that. Getting songs mixed and mastered. I'm like, I bring it to the club. I bring it to one of y'all. I just play it for me. Hey, man, bro, you need to get your song mastered. I'm like, what does that mean? Like, what y'all talking about? I need to get my song mastered. But I could hear the difference in the levels in my songs when, you know, when you play the song before mine and you play mine. I'm like, man, why so low? Like, what's going on? And the next song is way up there. But, you know, through time, you know, I learned the ins and outs, and I applied it to what I had going on. And now I try to get that knowledge to as many up-and-coming artists as possible. Like, anybody I ever do a song with, I'm in the studio with, and, you know, you could check up on it. Hey, bro, you need to get your song mastered, bro. Like, you got to. They all, nah, the person who did it said, hey, man, nah, that's what they told me. That's not no master, bro. You know, get your song mastered. Like, so, you know, when you go places and you present it to people, you really only get one shot. You go present it, and it ain't presented the right way. You know, you're gonna get put on the back burner, you know what I'm saying, for a real long time. So, you know, the amount of knowledge that I gained, you know what I'm saying, and the way I applied it, you know, it just did wonders for me.
The initial social media campaign, I'll never forget it for you. I mean, I swear it felt like 100 different accounts was tagging me to the flyers and right, the music right. And the baby, just everywhere. It's like, that was the hashtag, just the way they was pushing it.
Right.
And so that first project, you said that was Nonfiction?
Yeah, it was called Nonfiction.
How many?
2015.
How many tracks?
9 tracks. And it went crazy. Like, it went crazy. I think I put it up on just like that piff, and it went crazy. Put it out, and they gravitated towards it immediately.
So since then, how many songs would you say that you've recorded since then?
Oh, I got a catalog now. I got songs for days now, because I understand the business, and I know that just putting out content on top of content on top of content, you take away from what you're putting out. It's kind of like, you know, like treating your records like they're worth something. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's like if people be like, Michael Jordan got all this money, why don't he just put out a pair of Jordans every day? He can't do that because the value of the Jordans gonna go down. If I put out a pair of Jordans every day, what's gonna be special about that pair of Jordans, that last pair to drop? You know, you gotta give it time to sink in, make sure that it get around the way it need to get around. You know what I'm saying? So, and that's probably the best advice somebody ever gave me when it came to light show. They like, bro, you got something. You don't need to put out nothing else. Push this record. And I'm hard-headed. I'm real hard-headed. You know, I think I know everything. I'm like, nah, man. I make hits all day, I bit my tongue. I sat back, I listened, and boom, you know what I'm saying? It ended up going number 25 in the nation, you know? And while doing that, while that spreading and becoming hotter and hotter, I was able to just stay consistent, stay in the studio, and build a catalog, you know? And the music I got put away, bro, it's so crazy. Like, that's why I just be sitting back, just, you know, I just be laughing. I still don't sit back. I still go hard every day. I'm still recording constantly. I be in the studio later tonight. You know what I'm saying? Only time I ain't recording is when my voice gone. That's when I cheer. But, you know, like, it's the music I got put away, bro. It's so next level, bro. So next level. So, you know, all the people who, you know, expect me to follow the norms and do the things that people do to, you know, remain cool for these other men out here and things like that, to, you know, go get the little show money in the club and, you know, the type of things that people gravitate towards. I done had plenty of opportunities to, you know, use situations for publicity, you know what I'm saying? That other rappers, they'll die for them chances, you know what I'm saying? Like, from like 5-6 people trying to run in my crib, shot somebody, boom, I could have took off with it. I didn't even speak on it. You know what I'm saying? When Buck TV caught me outside the club with the, you know what I'm saying, the little situation at Cameo, when whenever went down at Cameo. Rappers, like people, the average people nowadays, especially people here, like, they'll take that and they'll run with it. They'll use it as, you know what I'm saying, positive, you know, like, not positive, but they will use it in a way to push what they got going on. But see, me, like, and the type of things I stand on, like, if it ain't all about what I got going on, I'm not even going to step into it, because I feel like that's nothing but a distraction to what you got going on. So when people say, you know, about the whole diaper thing, and I'm like, bro, like, did you forget, like, who I am? Like, I'm the baby, you feel me? Like, this is marketing that you see. They're saying nothing but marketing. Like, you know, all this premeditated, the way y'all responding to it, all that. Like, I love it. Like, y'all doing exactly what I wanted y'all to do. but y'all just doing it quicker. I'm like, okay, bet. You know what I'm saying? Like, y'all doing it quicker than I expected. You feel me? So it's perfect, you know, and I want them to keep it up, you know. Later on, we going to do a little hotline. We going to have people call us and tell us what they think about it live on Instagram, you know, and we going to do it like that. But, you know, it's, I love it, man. What we got going on right now, man, is premeditated murder. And I mean that in the most positive way possible. Like, not murder, like killing somebody, but perfectly executing an idea, putting it together, premeditated murder. That's what just took place.
So would you say in the last 2 years, 200 songs recorded now?
Oh, I ain't gonna say 200. I would definitely say 100. Without it. And see, you gotta think about like the features and everything I did. It's up there. It's a lot of songs. But see, me, one thing about me, I don't make songs that I feel like it's not a hit. Like, if I'm not feeling it off the rip, I won't even boom. Like, if I chill here after this interview, bro, and play you records for an extra 30 minutes, bro, you gonna be like, wow. Like, I ain't, like, okay, I knew it was like that, but bro, I didn't know it was like that. Like, bro, I blow my own mind every time. You know what I'm saying? Like, every time I go in, like, the way I approach, you know, these records and the way I put things together. And you see me, I'm in a diaper. So when it come to music, like, musically, when it come to what I do, I'm not afraid to, you know, go places that I ain't never been before. You feel me? So the type of music that I got, bro, is crazy. And the fact that I can make that, and I can make this type of music, the simple, you know, trap music, the type of records that people go crazy about every day, I can spit them out, you know what I'm saying? But I got these type of records over here that these people go crazy about every day. I'm talking about, you know, yeah, filling up arenas. I'm talking about, you know, going to UK to do shows, Japan. I got all that going on, you feel me? And it's just a blessing at the end of the day. And it's a blessing that I don't shy away from, you feel me? Like, you know, just my versatility, you know, and the fact that I'm different, I don't shy away from it, you know. I step to it, you know, and I stand on that.
You mentioned features.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Scream them.
I mean, I got a track with Tory Lanez that ain't been put out. I got a track with Trouble from Atlanta. I got a track with, who we got? Black Youngster. I got a short film with Black Youngster. Don't nobody got no short. I got a short film with Black Youngster. Who else we got tracks with, brother, we ain't put out?
I mean, I know you got Boosie on the
record. Yeah, Boosie. I got like two, yeah, I got like two tracks with Boosie. Boosie, Yo Gotti, Black Youngster, Trouble, Tory Lanez. I done worked with somebody else. Skipper the Flipper. Who else, man? And we in the process of getting tracks by some people that are, you know, it's gonna blow your mind. You know, it's really already been set in stone. Like, yeah, we gonna get it done, but you know, I ain't never one to really force no situation. It's even with me, like when I make music, like, people gotta understand, like, this art, you know what I'm saying? So ain't no forcing that. You just gotta let things happen the way they happen. I'm a firm believer in that. So, you know, in due time, you know, people gonna see. They gonna see. Cause, you know, any real artist, like, when they look at me, when they hear my music, when they see my demeanor, they understand, like, okay, wait, there's something right here. You know what I'm saying? I'ma chill, see. I'ma check on it in a couple months, but that's something right there. You know what I'm saying? And that's why, you know, I've been blessed to be a part of the team that I'm a part of, and have them type of people around me that work with legends, you know what I'm saying? And they believe in me 110%. They'll bet the house on me, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, we just gonna continue to do what we do and be blessed.
Your hit radio record, Light Show.
I got a lot of diamonds.
Produced by
Sean the First. The GOAT, the greatest.
What's your relationship like with these producers? Name some of these producers you've been working with.
That's my brother. Like, I really created my sound with First. I really created my sound with Sean the First. And we, see, the thing with me and him, he was already great when I met him. He'd definitely tell you the same thing about me. I was already great when I met him. But when me and him work, we make each other better, you know. And see, that's the best type of relationship to have with anybody, no matter what it is, artist, producer, whatever. Whatever type of relationship you got with anybody, making each other better, that's the best type of relationship, a mutually beneficial relationship. So Sean the First, man, you know, that's family right there, man. We really created the sound that I got together, you know. Slim Hood, he produced the new single, Coming Over. Real good dude. And all these people, they real good dudes. That's why we create the type of magic that we create. Because, you know, we get around each other. We vibe out. We work with each other. But it's different. It's different than just a producer that just want the quick little bread, you know what I'm saying, for throwing the beat together. That's way different, you know. But to sit around somebody, you know, learn their tendencies, learn the way they work, and, you know, chill and create, that's a completely different thing. That's where the magic come together at. You know what I'm saying? So, like when me and Shauna first, when we made a light show, a female friend, very special female friend, she bought me a $20,000 Cuban link. That's how I made a light show. She bought me a $20,000 Cuban link, solid gold, flooded with diamonds. You know, I went straight to the studio. I was feeling myself. I said, first, what's up? He said, how you feeling? That's how he asks when we create, how you feeling? I said, bro, diamonds. Look down, I said, diamonds. He started making a beat. We knocked the song out like quick. You know what I'm saying? So, and that's how it happened. But see, that's how a lot of great things happen. Even the second single coming over, I had like an extra keyboard. I had got a whole bunch of studio equipment and stuff that I wasn't using because I like people to know what they doing with the stuff. I don't know how to play no piano or none of that, but I always been about investing in myself and having everything I need right there. So I had all that stuff at the crib, but I wasn't using it, so I called him. You know, that's my dog. You know, we had did a lot of work together. Like I say, I like working with genuine people because I'm a genuine person. I called him, like, bro, you want this keyboard? He like, yeah. I'm like, I'm about to bring it to you. Pulled up on him, gave it to him. He like, bro, I'm about to give you a beat or something. He like, what you want? I said, bro, just, it don't matter. Give me a beat or something next time we cook up. He started making a beat right there on the spot. I'm playing around when I made Coming Over. Like, you see, that's like R&B. Like, that's completely different. And I made it. You got to think about it. I made it like 8-9 months ago. You know what I'm saying? So we just not pushing it. That's the only thing. I went in there. He playing the beat, the little R&B type beat. He playing with the sounds. I said, nah, keep it there. He playing with the beat. I went in there singing. I'm literally like laughing after I punch every line. Like I'm laughing like, oh, that's crazy. You know what I'm saying? Like that I could even, you know, switch gears and create something like that. And boom, you know, like I say, that's how the magic happened. Like even when I made Dab City, I was going to the studio to do a verse for Joe Blow. I was going to the studio. And this when I first linked up with Shauna first. I was going to the studio to this before Light Show and all that. Because Dab City really what turned it up when I made a song about the Panthers. Going to the studio to make to do a verse for Joe Blow. And first, he like, hey, I got something I got to play for you before you leave about it. I'm like, all right, bet. Not the verse out of Joe Blow. And he like, he played it. I was on my way out the door. He played the song. I said, bro, what you want for it? He told me, I'm like, all right, come on, load it up. Let's go. I jumped back in the studio. Ran through the whole song. Released it the day after. No, shot a video for it the day after because the Panthers happened to be playing Atlanta and it was undefeated and it went viral. You know what I'm saying? Charlotte Observer picked it up. It was all over the internet. It went crazy. I mean, when the Panthers lost just this past year when they ain't make it to the playoffs and stuff like that, people still commenting on the video like, ah, Panthers still can't get it done. You know what I'm saying? So, like, the craziest things, man, the best things, man, they just happened. They just happen in the moment, you know what I'm saying? So I'm real big on that, man, on you know, everything happening for a reason, you know, and the Most High putting you, you know, exactly where you need to be when you need to be there.
You mentioned the relationships that you have with these producers. These are producers that are from your town.
Right. All of them. I really don't. I barely got tracks from people. Like, I ain't big on that. But people got to understand about production, like, okay, it's cool to get a Metro Boomin and all that, but they can just give you anything. Like that just go back to what I'm saying, like having genuine relationships with people and people knowing your tendencies and the way you work and people having the patience to create with you, it puts you in a much better position than just getting a track from somebody that don't even know nothing about you or none of that. Like, they don't know how to cater to you. When I make these songs with these producers this year, you know, we sit around each other. We go through instruments. They go through, I'm like, okay, use that. Okay, they go through, they click through on the next part of the beat. They going through, you know, bass line. I'm like, use that one. While they sitting there playing around with the instruments, I'm behind them. If I catch the vibe, I start humming a melody or something and they'll hear me. Feed off of it. We boom, 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 boom. That's the way we work. You know what I'm saying? And me and Shauna first, like we like Shaq and Kobe with it. Like we boom, boom, boom. Like if he come in here right now with his laptop, I'll make a song right now. Like he come in here right now, we can make a hit like right here on air. You know what I'm saying? Like that's just the way it goes. So when it come to producers, man, and that's a big reason why I like working with producers here, mainly the few people that I have worked with, because, you know, we can create. I'm all about creating. Like, you know, I'm an artist. I ain't just a rapper. So, you know, the creativity level, you know, it's on 1,000.
You mentioned Honey Gang and you mentioned Joe Blow.
Yeah, definitely. Free Mo, by the way.
Definitely free money only Mo.
Uh-huh.
You still got good relationships with a lot of the artists from the town?
Yeah, the artists that I'm supposed to have good relationships with, you know, anything you do, man, and it don't, you know, that's not only with the music business, but say you play basketball, you know, people who want to be in your position or people who used to be in your position, that's no longer there that you surpassed. Like, it's just human nature for them to, you know, for them to feel some type of way about it. You just, you know, I'm in touch with that. I understand that. So I never, like, from the get-go, I never dabbled in the whole rapper beef or none of that. Like, I don't, that's not even real to me. Like, I don't even see that. I don't pay attention to that. I done had countless amounts of opportunities to, you know, feed into this or feed into that or respond to this rapper or respond to that rapper. Like, you know, I understand, like, what's up. I get it. You know what I'm saying? Like, I feel for you. The best thing I could do is just give you advice. You know, you gotta keep working. Like, when I first jumped out here, it was people that was better than me. You know what I'm saying? Like, I already felt like I was the best. You should feel like you the best. You know what I'm saying? Like, or we don't even need to be talking anyways if you don't feel like you're the best. You should feel like that. I expect you to feel that way. So, you know, when it comes to artists in the city, man, I respect, you know, the people who understand it. Ain't nobody gonna give you nothing when they come to this, you know. And see, them the type of artists that have problem with other artists. People that think, you know, you got handouts. They're, oh, man, these radio stations, they, you know, they riding them, man. They, you know what I'm saying? Yada, 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 yada. Nah, if you the hottest, you know what I'm saying? You the hottest, you know, you feel me? Like, when Icy Money had that,
It's together.
You know what I'm saying? It was the hottest track. You feel me? Yeah. Period. Like, that's what you gonna hear. I knew I was hot too. I ain't never hate on it. You know what I'm saying? Not one time. You just gotta understand, if you know, hey, take notes. You feel me? Take notes. Figure out a way. Sit back, regroup, keep working, figure out a way to, you know, put your play together and make yourself the best, you know. And that's pretty much, you know what I'm saying, what I did. You know, and it just go back and forth. You know what I'm saying? It's music. It just go back and forth. So when it come to, you know what I'm saying, relationships with artists, man, I try to just keep it cordial. You know what I'm saying? I don't never make nothing too personal. You know what I'm saying? Because when you do, then people feel like, you know what I'm saying, that you owe them something. And I don't make room for nobody to get offended. Like, that's how I've learned to play it. You feel me? I just, you know, it's what's up with it. Hey, keep doing what you're doing, bro. Love what you're doing. Appreciate it. You keep doing what you're doing, and we can just keep it at that. You know what I'm saying? Like, because it's just going to turn into, you know what I'm saying, ill feeling somewhere down the line. I done learned that, you know. Any rapper that feels some type of way about me and Charlotte, I guarantee you, before they wanted to have some type of relationship with me. In order to feel some type of way about somebody, you had to once have love for them. That's what people got to understand. People got to, you know, put all the other stuff to the side and realize, like, you know, what's really going on. Like, stay in touch with what's really going on. You feel me? Like, it should be no way, you know. Like, I can't have a problem with somebody about no rap that I used to admire. I could know what's up with you and just play it like that, but I can't speak ill on nobody that I used to admire. Like, it just don't make no sense. You feel me? Like, so, you know, I just play it like that, man. You know, and I wish every artist in the city the best. You feel me? Like, I ain't, you know, I'm the best, and I'm gonna say that, you know what I'm saying, forever. You know, I'm the best. So, you know, come take my spot. You know, that's what I be needing. Like, when artists sit back and just, you know, let me go on my run, and I don't feel no pressure. Like, I mean, now it's a little bit different because I look at myself like, I don't even, for the longest, like, I don't even put myself in that category with, you know, as a local artist. Like, it's way beyond that. You know what I'm saying? So now, like, I'm competing with the big boys. I'm trying to be better than your favorite rapper. I already feel like I'm better than your favorite rapper. So I'm like that with it. Like, man, it ain't five rappers better than me. Like, I'm going to say that. I'm with the straight face. You feel me? And we could do it. Play their songs. Let me play these songs you ain't heard. You know what I'm saying? We could do that. You know what I'm saying? Like, so that's what I'm on. Like, when it come to beefing about this, about that, or what side of town you from, or why you don't come here no more. Why you don't, man? Listen, check this out, bro. Like, you know, the type of stuff that I do, like, I'm all about my business. That's what you got to understand. And you're not gonna get to where I'm at. What you upset about, you're not gonna get over that. Thinking about the next man, you ain't never heard me speak on another rapper. Nobody has ever heard me speak on another rapper. If you did, go find it and show it to me. Never, you know what I'm saying? From day one, I ain't never spoke on another rapper in Charlotte. And I won't, you feel me? Because it's like, that's not going to get me nowhere. While people sitting around speaking on me, I'm somewhere putting this play together to do this, you know, and it shows. The results going to show every time, you know what I'm saying? So, but salute, you know what I'm saying, to every to every Charlotte artist doing their thing. Salute, big ups to y'all. Keep doing what you're doing, man. I give people the game, you feel me? I ain't no hidden secrets. Like, this work, you know, with these DJs, I want these DJs to show y'all love the way they show me love. Make them, you feel me? Like, it was times where I brought Meddi my music, and you're right, we can bring up another story. I'm like, bro, what's up? Like, you know, like, bro, like, I get it in. What's up? What type of music do I need to bring to you? Let me play this song, that song, and you tell me what you think about that and where you think I could take that. Meddi hit me back. You know what I'm saying? Hey. Honestly, this ain't the right tempo. He said I could never play this on the radio. You know what I'm saying? It's just simply not the tempo. He kept it straight up and down. Like, what you gotta understand, like, in anything you do, you gotta study the game that you in, and you gotta execute, you know what I'm saying, in a way. You gotta make it work for you. While staying in your own lane, you gotta make it work for you, you feel me? And that's what I had to do. I came and hollered at him, he gave me the advice, he gave me the game, I went back. Put everything together, then I came back with it. You know what I'm saying? And boom, you know what I'm saying? That's just the way it go. What people do, you know, they come holler at these people and they don't be where they need to be. People keep it real with them. They go get in their feelings about it and they turn it into something else. They make it about something else. It's not about that, bro. Like, it's not about you. Like, these people, they can care less. These DJs, these radio people, they can care less. And at the end of the day, they got a job to do too. You feel me? So they can't cater to another man's feelings. And why would they cater to your feelings if you the type of person where if you told no, now it's like you ain't never met them before. Now you talk on them, you know what I'm saying? Like they ain't nothing, you feel me? So you wasn't nobody to take that type of risk for anyways in the first place, you feel me? But that's just what people got to understand, man. You know, ain't nothing given to you. You know, if you try one time, it don't work. Go back, put the play together, come back, present it in another way. Do it again. I had to do that. You gonna have to do that. You know what I'm saying? Like, let's put everything else to the side. Like, you gonna have to do that. You can be the freshest rapper in the world. You can be the most gangster rapper in the world. Don't none of that matter. Don't none of that get you nowhere. What gets you somewhere is learning, you know what I'm saying, from your mistakes, soaking up as much game as possible and applying that to what you got going on. That's what's gonna get you somewhere.
South Coast Music Group behind you.
Oh yeah, most definitely.
And we just mentioned, you know, the independent music scene.
Yep.
So can Dababy have his own record label in the future? Can we see you going back and signing some of these artists that need you to be big brother now?
I be talking to the bro all the time. I be talking to Carter all the time. It's already like, you know, like one or two people that I would come snatch up and just give them the type of game that I got, like the way I just answered the last question. And still all that in them, and I know they'll be out of here. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, people just got to understand, you know, what to put first and how to prioritize, you know, what they think about when it comes to this game that we in. You feel me? But definitely, though, because I'm, like I say, I'm all about my business. So, you know, once I get there to where I can and invest in another artist and take it there and put them in position to feed their family and, you know, be blessed while still blessing myself, make something off of it, I'm going to do that. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's not something somebody going to have to force me to do. Right now, I can't do nothing for you. I can't save nobody. You feel me? Like, I'm not what you see, what you admire so much, it's still a working process. You feel me? What you admire so much, what you hate so much, it's still a working process. That's what people got to understand. Like, I'm still grinding every day. You know what I'm saying? I'm still, every time I get the bag, I put the bag right back into myself. Like, that's necessary. You feel me? If you want it, that's what's going to have to happen. You're going to have to give everything up for it. You know what I'm saying? So right now, I can't do nothing for you. I don't got nothing for nobody but some advice. You feel me? Now, if it makes sense for me to help you in a way, it's just going to happen naturally. Like, and nothing's going to be, you know, forced. Anything that I do, I don't want no recognition off of it. You feel me? Like, that's not what it's about. But, you know, definitely, like, I'm the person that's gonna do that. You feel me? I'm gonna do that if Big Homie don't sign everybody.
If Big Homie don't sign everybody.
If Big Homie don't sign everybody before me, man. If he don't beat me to him, so I'm gonna quit telling him who he need to get. Cause I told him about a cut, like, hey, like, all right, I'm like, hey, all right. So I'm gonna quit giving up my secrets. But nah, I ain't the type of person to, you know, my entire life, you know, making other people happy, putting other people in position to be happy and make other people happy. That's what helped me sleep at night. That's just what I do, you know. So I never, you know, keep any knowledge from anybody that'll help them get further. That's just not how I rock.
One of the female bloggers told me to ask you.
What's up?
You got Yo Gotti on the Light Show remix.
Mm-hmm.
How does that come together?
It's relationships. You know what I'm saying? It's like I said, it's all about relationships. The big homie, he worked with Yo Gotti. He talked to Yo Gotti every single day. You know, like, it's all about relationships. And that's what people got to understand. It's not about the bag, people. That's, yeah, he bought his way into where he... No. I invest the money into myself, but it's about them relationships. See, when you hollered at this DJ and they told you, and you flashed out, you went on the internet and started crying, you ain't understand. You just ruined the relationship. You feel me? If I would have hollered at Meddi, and Meddi would have told me that, you know, hey, this song right here, this not for radio. And I'd have got on the internet like, man, y'all niggas. I'm sorry. I'm cussed on the radio. But if I'd have got, you know what I'm saying? If I'd have got on the internet, though, like, man, y'all lame. Y'all only want to play Icy Money, man. And y'all only want to do this. And y'all only want to do that. I would have ruined the relationship with this person that got record labels calling him a couple months later, like, hey, who the hottest in the city? And now he's saying my name. You know what I'm saying? So that's what people got to understand, man. This business is 80%, no, 95% relationships, 5%, whatever else you think it is. Yeah. Straight like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, the Yo Gotti feature, a random would have tried to get that feature while he was in Charlotte. They would have had to pay $20,000 for it. Mm-hmm. Because I know somebody that know him, and my relationship with him is just as good as his relationship with Gotti. Boom. They know he the type of dude. Well, if he's stamping him, if he stand behind him like that, the type of love I got for him, I do it for free. Don't worry about it. And I come to y'all. He came here and did it. You know what I'm saying? So it's all love. And even after doing it, posted it on his Instagram, the type of stuff you got to pay for.
So the baby, of course, you know, everybody been talking about you walking around in the diaper.
Mm-hmm. What they say?
With the shirt off.
Right.
One of the first things I noticed, I know it's a group of girls, they wanted to grab you right there. You feel me?
Right. And I'm all for it. You know, I won't tell the police on you. Right.
So I have noticed over the time, man, like, man, you fit, bro. Do the baby work out on the road? I know, you, like you said, you got to find time to
eat. Right. On the road, I really don't be having time for it, man, for a little minute. And I just started this like a couple months ago. I was trying to hit the gym on the regular, you know, and the results, they were showing quick. But, you know, once we start getting back on that road and getting back to it, it barely be time for that. And by the time we get done doing what we doing, I be wore out. And then I don't be eating the way, you know, I normally eat. So my body be, you know, like, I don't be having no extra energy to go work out if I ain't eat the right way. So it be inconsistent now. But, you know, it's just these genetics.
You know, it's just these genes, you know, at any given moment I might just break down, you know, just give you about 50 of these, man.
Hey, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 30, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 40.
All right, so yo, so definitely before I let you get up out of here, tell them how to get in tune with your movement, just in case they're not in tune with your movement.
All right, at BabyJesus704, that's all social media outlets. That's at BabyJesus704, Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, all of the above. If you do the Facebook thing, Facebook.com/BabyJesus704. All music is available on all digital platforms. That's iTunes, Apple Music, Spotify, Google Play, Tidal, all of the above. You can catch all the visual content on YouTube. You know, and that's just the way to keep up. You know, if you stay in touch with the Instagram, I'm pretty much on top of that. So any of that other information, if it does change, like where I'm releasing music at, you can find it out there.
All right, definitely. All right, we're about to go ahead and let you get up out of here.
Okay.
So is the next single coming over? All right, tell me about this record.
Call my phone, I'm coming over. The best thing I could tell y'all about this record, don't let your girl hear it. That's the best thing I could tell you. Don't let your girl hear it. But no, it's a beautiful record, man. Beautiful record. It's definitely going to set the vibe. It's something that you want to ride to while you got your girl in the car. You feel me? Like, it's a beautiful record. And with the type of records I got coming in the future, it's set to play right up. You know what I'm saying? So, but it's one of the favorites. Like, I believe in letting the people choose the singles. And that's one of the ones they chose. When I perform it, they go crazy every time. They be raping me. So, you know, coming over it is. Call my phone, I'm coming over. And speaking of that, we about to put the number on IG. We about to start doing this a lot too. So if you miss this opportunity, I don't know when the interview gonna drop. It'll be another chance. Just stay in touch with that Instagram that I gave you. We gonna create the, you know, the baby hotline. You can call in. It's gonna be called Baby Talk. You call in and just tell us what you, you know, tell us what you think, how you feeling, all that.
Well, there it is, mm-hmm. Baby Jesus. Appreciate you coming through, man.
Appreciate you having me, bro.
It's all love.
The baby. And every time I'm in the whip in Charlotte, man, you know who I'm riding to, man. Streaks 103.3. Quit playing.